Hi, and welcome to the Live News Breakfast Report. Democratic Alliance leader Helen Ziller addressed thousands of people at the DA's election manifesto launch in Polokwane on Sunday. Ziller promised to address jobs, education, corruption and crime. She stated that education is important in fighting crime and corruption and in securing millions of real jobs. In a statement on Sunday, the Higher Education Transformation Network said that the entire Northwest University management needs to be urgently relieved of their duties. Hendrik Makaneta called on the Minister of Higher Education to urgently appoint an administrator to take over the management of the university. This following reports that students at the province's university used the Nazi salute during an initiation ceremony. Two brothers were killed after being hit by a car allegedly driven by a radio personality on Sunday morning. Brigadier Tulane Ngubane stated the man's name will not be released until he appears in court to face charges of two counts of culpable homicide, charges of reckless or negligent driving, drunken driving, and failing to stop and help at an accident. And in sporting news, South Africa beat Australia by 231 runs in the second test in St George's Park in Port Elizabeth on Sunday. South Africa declared in the morning session as they moved to 270 for 5 in their second innings. Australia were bowled out for 216. The visitors witnessed a batting collapse after they reached 126 for no wickets before they lost 10 wickets for 90 runs. Stay tuned for more live news.